Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about a half-truth. And this industry of acoustics is full of half-truths. Exaggeration, hyperbole, all the nonsense human beings tack on to things. So, but let's just focus on the science. And 18 years of phone calls with this double wall half-truth. So let's talk a little bit about it. I probably get 5-10 calls a week from people that have used this double wall option to reduce noise transmission. So we're going to examine step by step each part of it so you get a feel for why it doesn't work and why it works at certain frequencies and not others. So we all know what it is. It's 2x4s with 2 2x4 walls with an airspace. Now, that airspace, I've seen anywhere in the literature from 1 inch to 6 inch. There's no, you know, set distance on that, which tells me nobody knows what they're doing. Because there should be some consistency here. The data should support that. But the calls I get consistently from people are, it's great for vocals, stops the noise from voice, does nothing for the low end. That's because it can't. So this is another half-truth that the industry is full of. I mean, you hear it all the time. Oh, the double wall. And when people call me and they have a noise issue, their first thinking is the double wall. What you have to realize is you're taking up a lot of space. Maybe, what do you got? 3.5, 3.5, 7 plus the airspace. Let's say 2 inches. You're going to use 9 inches of space to stop voice. Because it won't deal with low frequencies. It's not designed to. There's not enough mass to deal with low frequency. Because low frequency is vibrational acoustics. And building a wall with an airspace isn't... It addresses the vibrational transmission, but it doesn't do it effectively. Okay, it was a technology developed years ago, 20, 30, 40 years ago. It's not applicable today. We've advanced in materials, designs, and knowledge, okay? So, problem with this structure, it won't stop energy below 125 hertz. And we get calls all the time verifying that. People use it in their home theaters. They give up 9 inches of space, 8 inches, whatever it is. And they're not happy with the transmission of the low end to other rooms in the house or neighbors or office buildings or whatever the usage is. So, we can treat voice in 3.5 inches. So if you're going to build a wall and put 2-inch airspace between 2 2x4 walls to stop voice and take 9 inches, we can do it in 3.5. Because we understand vibration transmission. We know how to stop it. And we'll show you a graphic at the end about that. So the bottom line with this structure is it's too much space requirement and no performance. I mean, if you're going to give up 9 inches of space, you should have full frequency range of treatment, right? You should be able to cover all frequencies at 9 inches. Our carbon panel's 12 inches deep, starts at 40 hertz, goes to 6,300. So that'll give you an idea of what you can do in 12 inches. But when we're dealing with voice and low frequency, we have to be more concerned with density and mass, okay? So we use what's called a sandwich technique. It's vibrational acoustics. Remember, what we're trying to do is take a big airborne energy wave that strikes a wall, and we want to make it come back smaller on the other side. So we have to reduce the vibration of this energy so that less comes out on the other side. So that's what our goal and objective is with vibrational acoustics. So our sandwich technique does more in less space. That's the key. Because you don't want to give up space. Our rooms are small to begin with, too small in most cases. But we want to make sure that we get the job done. The nice thing about our sandwich technique is it's easy to integrate into a wood frame structure. You can see here in the graphic different layers of materials. This is for a particular noise problem. That's why we have to measure all the noise always. Because every material in the sandwich is based on frequency and amplitude of the noise. Every material, okay? And the way it's constructed is also a factor. if you have lower frequency noise here, then this first layer has to have a higher density than the rest of them. And there's a whole science to vibrational acoustics. So that's why it's important to measure the noise first, because if you measure the noise, we're not going to waste materials, and we're not going to waste space, and we're not going to waste labor. So I don't remember what this graphic was for, but it was one of our projects. We have a whole series of these sandwiches that work in a wood frame wall. Poured concrete, brick, that's a little bit different. We'll just add to that density. But if it's a wood frame and you got a noise issue, this is the way to go. It takes up less space and performs better. So once again, you know, the double wall, it works for voice, but not for low frequency. So we call that a half-truth, and the industry's full of it. And it confuses people, and I get that. I understand that. Drives me nuts, confuses people. So double wall, half-truth. Stick with the sandwich technique. You'll get better performance in a smaller amount of space. Hope this helps. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that, because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.